Today we're going to review reading the display on your aging room control. When you look at the control, you should see the display that's currently being shown here. If not, press the home button. Once you see the screen, you will see on the upper left the current dry bulb temperature in your room. To the right is the current dew point temperature in your room. To the lower left is the dry bulb temperature that you are looking for the room to be maintained at. To the right of that is the desired dew point temperature you're looking for the room to be maintained at. Pressing the More button takes you to the next screen where you can see more information about what the control is doing. On this screen, you can see the relative humidity in the room on the left, and on the right, you can see what the vapor pressure is in the room expressed in millibars. This is the force of the water that would be exerted on the product that you have in the room. Pressing the More button takes you to the next screen. On this screen, you can see the speed that your fan should be running at and the position of the refrigerant suction valve. Some controls, instead of having a fan output, will have a damper output, and instead of a suction output, might have a chilled water output, but the effect is the same. The fan output is a function of the temperature, dry bulb temperature in the room, and the suction or chilled out is a function of the dew point in the room. Pressing the More button takes you to the next screen. On this screen, you can see the position of the auxiliary heat relay, the auxiliary humidity relay, and a liquid line solenoid. All three of these are optional depending on the particular application. Pressing the More button takes you back to the home screen. In the upper right, there might be a little black dot flashing. This dot indicates that something in the control is overridden, and we will cover how to override values in the control in another video.